They're going down to be on the pump. So you got a minute. Now what he's doing is he's bringing the, he's bringing the pressures up, he's checking the oil, make sure everything is oiled good. See the little oil bubble going up right there? Then he's checking all the valves, making sure there's no leaks. Then he's going to the other side, he'll cut that one line off, and then he'll come back over here and he'll put this one on. So turn this one off, turn that one on.
So this is a 1909?
No, this was, it stopped working in 1909. It was built in 1898. And then was...
What's the model, name of it?
It's a, right here, American. It's a company, American Fire Engine. Yeah.
Company.
And it was a predecessor, I think, of American La France, is that correct? And then right here is when it was patented,
yeah,
right here,
1898.
1898. And it went into service in 1899.
Okay,
in
so we're going to let her rip?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, when he cranks that one, are they going down? Okay, yeah, he's going.
Hey,
we got to have
fire,
him down there on the
this
monitor.
This is District 17 fire cadet. What's your name?
Kevin.
Kevin Will.
Handle the monitor.
Okay, he's going to go operate this.
Yep.
All right.
The other guy.
My lieutenant's going to go do it.
Okay, better yell at your lieutenant. Hey, lieutenant.
Hey.
See the water coming up here?
Yeah,
the
water starts.
That's water right there.
Okay, is he gonna do it?
Okay.
Alrighty.
Okay.
Okay, here it goes. It's pretty spectacular.
We're going down.
How many feet do you think you get?
I don't know. I'd say a good
150 feet.
And it'll go up as high as those trees.
Okay, here goes. Gonna do the
warning. They're ready. See, they're ready.
The warning. Zoom in.
Alright, so close in on that.
Okay.
Now, when he comes back over to this, what he'll do is he'll crank that up. That's like the throttle.
I know.
And then he'll take this down.
There it goes!
That's just a little bit.
Yeah.
That's only about 100 feet out there.
Back.
There we go.
What he did was adjusted like the throttle here, increased it, and he's got more heat going through. He's burning up that wood that I piled in there just real quick. But it's working, pumping about 950 gallons a minute. And everything's fine. He's watching the gauges, make sure everything's good. We're making sure we don't run out of water because it'll captivate and it'll pull air. So he's watching that real close. We can pump that all that water out in about probably 4 or 5 minutes. 6 minutes. He's pumping 950 gallons a minute. Now he's checking the gauge. See the gauge right here? 30 pounds we come down to, but he's still pumping that water way up. It's amazing, this torque.
Yeah.
Steam has more torque than any other medium. Now by his hand there, that's 300 degrees on those pipes.
Oh.
And that's the part that pushes it up and down is here. That's the centrifuge that makes it work. This is the pump down here. Pump itself going up and down. These balls and stuff are to make the pressure stay equal. The big one there was developed in about 1867 to get rid of the pulsation. So in other words, the water would run back and forth on this big ball here like this. There you are, the camera person right there. But these are the gauges. We're down to 25 pounds and yet we're still kicking it out at probably 800 gallons. This one here is this one fluctuating. The pump is measuring the pressure in here, and this is the actual water. This is the water going out at 60 pound pressure out there. Hear it? How it sounds like a steam engine now?
Yeah. That's really cool.
Now he's burned up all the wood, and then he's gonna a couple minutes. He's gonna complain that the guy didn't soak it well enough. But that's me. That's fine. That's fine.
Oh. tripped on that.
Here, change. Change the valve up there.